44 employees, nearly a third of the state's primary tourism marketing agency's staff, were given pink slips today. As Jake Stofan tells us, the employees are collateral damage in a political battle over the future of that agency.
Employees at Visit Florida's Tallahassee headquarters were told in an email not to come to work Thursday. Instead, dozens of employees were told to arrive for a meeting to discuss their futures and bring any Visit Florida property with them.
The layoffs are no fault of the employees themselves. Instead, it's the result of a $26 million cut in funding, a compromise between the House, which wanted to kill the agency altogether, and the Senate, which wanted to fully fund Visit Florida at $76 million.
With all the back and forth in the legislative session, people's lives are being affected.
Governor Ron DeSantis helped fight for the compromise, but says he's open to reforming the agency.
I didn't think letting it run aground now would have been the right thing for the state. It's going to be something we're going to have to look at.
Visit Florida had been funded at about $75 million for the past 5 years, up from $50 million previously. The Florida Restaurant and Lodging Association told us during last year's budget battle that tourism numbers skyrocketed when funding jumped from 50 to 76 million.
Soon to be 120 million visitors. That is directly correlated back to the amount of money we're spending on advertising.
But some marketing experts say the cuts could result in more efficient spending by the agency.
Now they'll be streamlining and looking at digital ads to market to the rest of the world.
The employees that are left will return to work Friday, but their jobs aren't necessarily safe. It's likely another funding battle will play out in the 2020 legislative session. Reporting from the state capitol, Jake Stofan, Channel 4, the local station.